So after riding for about 30 odd kilometers from Mirzapur, very bad roads, narrow. It's basically you travel through small towns and villages, something, you reach to this road which is Mirjan road. So we have another 45 kilometers before we take a deviation. Again, this road is not the best of the road, I can say. It is manageable. You have these regular bad patches here and there, so the minute you think you can throttle and you start throttling again, you'll have to slow down because the roads are bad. And one more thing, the observation in this particular route is once you take this highway or whatever state way that is, national highway or the state highway, you will see a lot of heavy lorries. Probably these are the lorries which are coming from Maharashtra to probably Karnataka, whatever. You'll see a lot of heavy lorries getting, you know, whatever stuff that is. But then the roads are definitely not so good. So, not really enjoying this. At the same time, not kind of bored. It's keeping me agile. It's keeping me alert though, which is a good part. So you see these lorries, so these are very frequent here, so you'll see a lot of them. And also you need to be a little careful with these guys because they come in like in lane, like multiple of them. So before overtaking, make sure you honk and all those things, because suddenly they'll kind of come right or left, so that's a little scary bit of it. And especially with the roads are being so bad, what also they do is, not intentionally, they might see a pothole and without giving indicator they take a right and probably you're going to overtake them. So you'll have to be literally alert when you take on to this road. So yeah, quite interesting. So just reached Yellapur, so we are clocking in 11:30. So from here I think it's either Hubli, and from there there's a deviation or something like that, so I'll have to figure out. So this is Yellapur town. So it says about 4 hours 50 minutes for my next destination. When I say my next destination, is my final destination for the day, which is Kolhapur. So yeah, it's a small town, so I will take a break around 1 o'clock. I don't want to take an unnecessary break unless it needs one. The weather has been quite pleasant, which is a blessing in disguise. It's not rainy, it's not too cloudy either, it's just a little shady in between being cloudy and sunny, so which has helped me maintain my pace and, you know, stay cool, stay calm, most importantly to keep myself hydrated. So the road that is the deviation that you take from Gokarna till Yellapur, I must say roads are pretty bad. I mean, you know, it's on and off patch kind of a thing, and you basically are doing the state highway. And once you cross Yellapur, then I think that's the national highway that you get, which is National Highway 52. And this, I have to now go about 50 odd kilometers before I take a deviation, or 37 odd kilometers before I take a deviation. So from Yellapur to Kolhapur is about 230 kilometers. And Google auntie says estimated time that I will reach Yellapur is about 5:15 in the evening. And yeah, I want to reach it Kolhapur even before that. Then maybe check into a room and then relax and all of it. But then that's again subject to my breaks that I'll take. So as of now, this timing is as per the break I'm taking. So now it's about 12 o'clock in the noon, the roads are pretty good, so I hope I can recover the time that I had lost while covering the route from Gokarna to Yellapur. Though it was just 70 odd kilometers, I took about, I think, an hour and a half plus. So hopefully now we'll be able to recover those lost time. And maybe that's what we'll have to do with this current road. This is good national highway, well maintained, not so many potholes like the ones which were there earlier. And if time permits, if I reach and if I'm able to reach Kolhapur, I would want to visit the Mahalakshmi temple at Kolhapur. I believe it's very, very famous and very powerful temple. So why not go get some blessings there as well, and you know, just pay a visit. So that's what the idea is. So now the weather, even if you look at it, so near Yellapur it was raining a bit, but then I had to go figure out the memory card and finally got a memory card at Yellapur. So I wanted to pick up the 128 GB memory card, but then it was super expensive. They were saying about 3500 rupees when I was asking for negotiation and discount. He said no, 35 is the best that he can offer. So I ended up picking a 64 GB memory card. So what I will probably do is, once I reach Kolhapur, I'll shift or transfer all the data to my hard disk. The only downside, I can't say it's a downside, but then you know, the only thing is that these are more of a straight line, you know, line of sight roads than those curvy and twisty roads. Because if you're traveling in between curvy and twisty roads, you are always agile and you know, you kind of keep yourself busy. I'm not too sure, what did I just see crossing? It was definitely a wild animal which just crossed by. Oh, don't know. Yeah, like I was saying, you really are agile and all of it, but then once you are on the straight road, yes, you can do good timing, you can cover up, but then it gets very boring and monotonous, and yet you know, sometimes you might feel sleepy as well. So I'm keeping myself occupied as much as possible, and you know, trying to be awake. Yes, that's what I'm trying to keep myself awake. So we take a deviation here, that's what it says, and this will go towards Hubli. So we have to go on this road for 21 kilometers before we take the next deviation. By the looks of this, it does not look like it's going to be a straight good ride. It's definitely going to be a bumpy ride. Again, the bad roads starts here. So the minute you get onto these village roads or the small town roads, this is what the problem is. They all are very bad. I mean, not well maintained, and that's time consuming. That it could be a shortcut, I'm not too sure, but then at the end of the day, the shortcut really does not work out. The reason is, you will probably take the same amount of time taking the highway, maybe a longer route, and taking the shortcut with these bad roads. So they compensate there. I don't know if I've spoken too early, but then let's go and see the next 21 kilometer, how it's gonna be. The last couple of kilometers which I came was brilliant. I mean, highway, what more can I expect? Very good roads. So it's maintaining good 80-90s on that. And here comes the challenge, because you can't maintain 80-90s on these roads. So let's see what best we can do here. So after Yellapur, I think this is the second bad patch that I'm coming across. So Yellapur was the first bad patch, and this is second, and this shows 21 kilometers. So if the 21 kilometers is this bad, then it becomes really tiresome. So tiresome in the sense that you are unnecessarily wasting your time on the road. It's about 19 kilometers and I am about 3 hours 40 minutes away from Kolhapur. So I think that should be about, what, how many kilometers now? 210 kilometers. What? Okay. And to make things worse, see these speed breakers, which are not even colored, and suddenly they come in right in front of you, and they can be problematic. Oh, see that, that was another speed breaker. Could not even see it. A, they haven't painted this, and B, because of bad road conditions, they all look the same. I mean, there's no differentiation between the speed breakers and the road, normal road. So actually what had happened was, the initial idea was that we do the coastal road, stay at Sawanth Wadi today, and tomorrow we start from, you know, take the Amboli Ghat and get towards the location. That is if my friends had joined me, that is my friends from Bangalore, Jobo and his team. But then for some reason they could not join me, due to which I had to change my plans. So I had to redo my plans, and then, you know, that's why I'm taking the Kolhapur road. I have done the coastal road couple of times, the, you know, entire coast. So I wanted to take a deviation and check out this bit, because this I haven't ridden at all, this part of the country. As in, when I say this part of the country, especially from the Mangalore bit towards Kolhapur side types. So yeah, that's the main reason why I took this route. So for you all, you know, it started raining, and I had to get my rain liners on. So yes, managed to get my rain liners. Doesn't seem like this is gonna last too long. I thought I'll continue, but then didn't want to take chances, so just stopped. And geared up with my rain liner. So I had to stop going forward. Once I take a deviation somewhere, I had to stop for my lunch break, which will be soon. Okay, let's continue. Okay, now comes the test of the rainproof film. So I've got the anti-fog and rainproof film, both of it. So let's see if it really makes any difference of a life. Because the anti-fog definitely did work, no doubt about it. But not too sure about the rainproof. So yeah, it's not raining heavily, but it's kind of a drizzle that you can see. So this has been a beautiful ride for the it has been a beautiful ride so far. So I had got a good nice early morning weather, and then got a good kind of a, what do I say, cloudish weather. So I'm not able to exactly make out if this is working or not. Not too sure. It is clear, but then not too sure as to this is how it is supposed to be, or you know. And definitely the vision is much clearer than the normal visor. If the normal visor had to be there during rain, it's definitely better than that. But then I'm not too sure if this is exactly how it is supposed to be. So we take a right turn here, which will take us towards Dharwad, I believe. Right turn here. So this road's very, very familiar to me. I used to come via this road, yeah, Dharwad, while going to Goa. Take this road. So that used to be a common road for us. Yes, so that road used to join from there. So the one which you can see from here, that's the Bangalore road which joins here. And here there's no rain. The rain liner which I wore was for hardly less than a kilometer. And here you see it's all sunny and good bright weather. Okay, so I will have to take the rain liner, otherwise it'll start getting suffocating. It'll definitely be too hot if you just wear the rain liner and continue. The pant is still okay, but not the upper one. I think there's a lorry bay somewhere. Vaguely remember that. If that's there, I'll probably take a break at the bay and have my lunch and relax there for a couple of minutes, or maybe 10 odd minutes, stretch a little bit and then start. I've taken off my gloves because they got a little wet. I will probably use my short gloves which I bought. Wasn't feeling too comfortable using the wet gloves, so just took it off for a little bit. And maybe now we'll just stop here somewhere, because it's a good place to stop here and kind of have my lunch, figure out a place to stop. So let me just finish off all this toll road and all of it, get to a place as in where I can sit down and you know. I think I need to get back to the Belgavi road. Oh, that's a straight road again. I need to remove my rain liners as well, because now it's fine, but in a while it'll get too stuffy, you know, because your jacket won't breathe and there's not enough wind bit. So Sai Aranya is a restaurant. Nope. I will park in a bay. Oh, I could have taken the service road and then parked there. Okay, I still have that bay line here. I'll take the bay, get in here, stop for a bit. I'll see a shade, stop in a bit, have my lunch, what I've got, get some water, hydrate myself, and then maybe get back to the main road. This seems to be okay with me. Okay, there's enough shade. Up. Let's put this on main stand and let me show you what I've got for lunch. Where is my lunch? Okay. That's pretty much my lunch now. It's completely mashed. Whoa. I don't think that will be sufficient. I'll just eat it for now and then maybe stop another place for something else. Okay, I'll finish the lunch and I'll get back to you. Yes, it's time for lunch and I'll see you guys once I hit the road again.